Hi, I'm Victor Cohen. This is the MCAT for Victory Anki course, and today we're going to talk about the required and recommended Anki add-ons. Anki's code is open sourced, meaning users can make changes or additions to the code. This creates an environment where users have made the application far more powerful. Students who use the MCAT for Victory Anki deck will want to download some add-ons to make the learning experience run smoother. Downloading an add-on is a relatively easy process that does not take much time. I've divided some of my favorite add-ons into two sections. In the first section, we'll be going over required and highly recommended Anki add-ons. In the second section, we'll be going over other recommended add-ons that will make the experience run smoother and more fun. Before diving in, I'm going to show you how to install Anki add-ons. To install an add-on, click on Tools, then Add-ons, then press Get Add-ons, and paste the code here. After that, press OK, and the add-on that you just downloaded will appear here. Then restart Anki to make sure the add-on installs properly. The codes for the add-ons covered in the video can be found in the description below. Now, let's start talking about the different add-ons. And we'll start by going over the required add-ons. The most important required add-on is Hierarchical Tags. To understand this add-on, you first have to understand the difference between decks and tags. The MCAT for Victory Anki deck is divided into multiple subdecks, including chemistry and physics, biology and biochemistry, and psychology and sociology. This is to help you study the different MCAT sections separately. Meanwhile, the tags are a different mechanism to organize the cards within the deck. After opening the browser, the tags can be found on the left-hand column. Without the add-on, it is extremely difficult to use the tags for studying. But with the add-on, the tags are properly organized. You'll be able to find the cards directly related to the MCAT video you are studying. Since it is incredibly important to learn the material before trying to memorize it, this add-on is the most important. The next required add-on is Load Balancer. While Anki was built to improve memorization through spaced repetition, sometimes cards may accumulate on certain days. Finishing all your cards may then be extremely difficult some days, while other days may have almost no cards. This creates an unpredictable Anki schedule, which can result in falling behind on your cards. The Load Balancer add-on fixes this problem by shifting the cards by a few days to make them appear a little sooner or a little later in order to make your schedule more streamlined. This will help improve the predictability of your Anki studies, making it easier to fit it into your daily schedule. It is very important to finish all your cards every single day. By studying every single day, the flashcards will not accumulate and will instead be distributed to make your studying easier and more effective. The next required add-on is only required for those who are right-handed. The MCAT for Victory Anki deck was built to help you study a lot of material as fast as possible. However, using your mouse to select whether you got a card right or wrong really slows you down. There is a built-in shortcut where you can use the buttons 1, 2, 3, and 4 to select wrong, hard, good, and easy respectively. But this is especially inefficient for those who are right-handed. For that reason, the next required add-on is Customized Keyboard Shortcuts. This add-on lets you make your own shortcuts to select wrong, hard, good, and easy. To make these changes, go to Tools, then Add-ons, click on Customize Keyboard Shortcuts, then Config, and then scroll down until you see Reviewer Choices. Reviewer Choice 1 is Again, Choice 2 represents Hard, 3 is Good, and 4 is Easy. Change these to J, K, L, and semicolon, respectively. Note that the spacebar will also select Good. This allows you to place your right hand in a relaxed manner on your keyboard and quickly go through your cards. The next required add-on is Pop-up Dictionary. While studying, you will often find separate cards that are related to each other. Instead of having to use the browser to find related cards, Pop-up Dictionary will allow you to search any word throughout your deck by simply highlighting the word. This will help you form connections between your cards in order to improve your memorization and retention. The final required add-on is called Speed Focus Mode. This add-on will help improve your focus, and it will help ensure that you finish all your cards as quickly as possible. This add-on works by making Anki automatically show you the answer to the card after a certain amount of time elapses. This prevents you from dozing off or spending too much time trying to think of the right answer. At one point, it is best to just select that you got the card wrong and move on. You can change the settings by clicking the gear icon, then clicking on Options, and selecting General. I recommend that you automatically show the answer after 15 seconds. Some of you will feel like this is too much time, while others will feel like you need more time to think. While aiming for around 10 seconds per card is recommended, you may need more time for certain cards, especially as you get used to using Anki. Feel free to change this setting, and especially if you want to shorten the time. Now that we have finished going over the required add-ons, let's switch gears to go over the recommended add-ons. Some of these add-ons can be used for efficiency, while others will improve the look of Anki. We'll be going over through these add-ons in the order of most useful to least useful. The first recommended add-on is called Edit Field During Review Cloze. This simple add-on will help you actively edit the cards quickly while you study. Without the add-on, you'd have to press E on your keyboard or click on the Edit button before being able to change the information on the card. But with the add-on, you can quickly click on the field and edit the card without having to disrupt your studies. The next recommended add-on is called Life Drain. This add-on helps gamify Anki, or you can use it to study using the Pomodoro technique, which I highly recommend you try. The Pomodoro technique is a research-proven method to help improve focus and efficiency. To use the technique, set a timer to study for 25 minutes. During those 25 minutes, you must limit distractions and concentrate exclusively on your studies. Then, after the 25 minutes are up, take a 5-minute break. When the break ends, restart the Pomodoro cycle. After 4 Pomodoro cycles, take a longer 15 to 30 minute break. While breaks are recommended to prevent burnout, they are not necessary when you are feeling strongly motivated to study. To set up the Pomodoro method with Life Drain, click the gear icon and select Life Drain. The units for all the options are in seconds. The maximum time is the length of the study session. Set this to 1500 seconds to study for 25 minutes. The Recover is a way to gamify Anki, where you gain a few seconds to the countdown every time you answer a card right. This should be set to 0 for the Pomodoro method. Enable Damage is also used to gamify Anki, where you lose a few seconds from the countdown every time you answer a flashcard wrong. This should also be set to 0 for the Pomodoro method, or turned off. Finally, the Current Life is how much time you currently have left to study. You should set this to 1500 seconds before starting your studies. If, on the other hand, you do want to gamify Anki, I recommend you make the maximum time 300 seconds, the Recover 18 seconds, and the Current Life 300 seconds. If you want an extra challenge, make the Recover 20 seconds and set Enable Damage to 3 seconds. You can play with these settings to make it easier or more challenging. You can also change the look of the Life Drain by selecting Tools, clicking Add-ons, clicking Life Drain, and pressing Config. Make sure Enable Life Drain is selected. Also, select Bottom for the position, make the height 15, the border radius 0, the text none, and select Default for style. Then, make the color a dark blue to decrease distraction. Next, I recommend you download Image Occlusion Enhanced. This add-on is useful for creating flashcards based on images. It allows you to hide portions of the image to quiz yourself on more visual processes. For example, let's say you wanted to quiz yourself on glycolysis. After downloading the add-on, create a new card by pressing A on the keyboard or by clicking on Add. Then, click the Add Image Occlusion icon and find the image you want to use. Every time you click and drag with your mouse, you create a new card. You can also group multiple selections to join them into a single card. To group, hold down Shift and click on the occlusions you want to group. Then press G on your keyboard. There are many other options that you can play around with to make your cards. Finally, select Hide All Guess 1 to make all the occlusions hidden, and try to answer the hidden one that is red. Alternatively, select Hide 1 Guess 1 to make all the occlusions go away except for the red one you are answering. Studying Anki every single day is a huge commitment. Failing to consistently study will result in a large accumulation of cards, which may make you feel overwhelmed. However, if you know that there is an important holiday coming up or a day where you will not be able to study, it is important to block that day off as soon as possible with a free weekend add-on. With this add-on, you can either block off a holiday or a specific day of the week. Those who are Orthodox Jews, for example, cannot use technology during Shabbat, so they can use this add-on to prevent cards from being scheduled on Saturdays. This add-on can also be useful for anyone who would like to take a weekly break day, or anyone who has an upcoming event and knows they will not be able to study for that day. However, the downside to this add-on is that using it weekly would mean your daily workload will increase. If you would have studied 300 cards a day, and you take one day off per week, that would mean that you would have to study around 350 cards per day with the add-on. The following three add-ons are useful for visualization of data and improving the looks of Anki. Advanced Browser gives you additional filters in the browser, which is useful for finding specific cards. It helps you filter by lapses, overdue interval, percent correct, and more. Another useful add-on is True Retention by Card Maturity Simplified, which adds additional data for your statistics. This add-on will help you visualize data for your learned cards compared to your mature cards over a period of time. Next up is Review Heatmap, which is one of my personal favorite add-ons. This add-on creates a grid below your deck where each square represents a day you studied. The darker the colored square, the more cards you studied that day. Meanwhile, lighter colored squares represent days where there were fewer cards studied. The add-on also shows you your future predicted schedule with gray squares. Again, the darker the gray, the more cards you will have to study that day. With the Load Balancer add-on, your daily workload will hopefully be relatively consistent as long as you finish all your reviews every day. Review Heatmap will motivate you to study every day by showing you your longest streak and your current streak. Streaks show you how many days you have studied in a row. The final recommended add-on is Customized Background Images and Gears Icon. This add-on lets you change the look of Anki. Instead of opening the app to see a boring gray screen, you can add exciting images to the background. You can also change the gear icon to something more fun. We have some downloadable images you can use for the background under this video. To change the background and gears, click on Tools, hover over Custom Background Gear Icon, and select Background Gear Image Folder. You can add new backgrounds to this folder, which will be displayed on your Anki home screen. Once you have added the image you want to the background and gear, you can exit the folder. Then click Tools, hover over Custom Background Gear Icon, and select Setup Background / Gear. On this screen, you can add the name of the image you want for the background and gear. You can also change additional features, which are all explained on the right. Restart Anki after downloading all these add-ons to make sure they are installed. And that is where I'm going to end this episode. In this video, we covered the required and recommended Anki add-ons. There are many more fun add-ons that you can explore once you feel comfortable doing so. Next episode, we will go over all the Anki terminology.